Hello children, good morning to you all. Yesterday I have started the lesson The Great Sand Artist. Right, I couldn't complete it due to some disturbances in roundabout neighboring area. That's why I stopped it in the middle. I'm going to continue it today. Okay, artist means the person who inculcated or developed some art in himself, like art of singing, art of dancing, art of painting, carving, sculpture. Sculpture means chakkadam, bommal chakkadam, kattelal toti, rai toti, inka devi totaina. But here is an art we are going to know about, the sand art. A person called Sudarshan Patnaik sculpted, means carved the shapes out of wet sand, for which he got World Cup award also. As we have World Cups for cricket, football or kabaddi, any other games, no? Same way here, World Cup award is meant for sand sculpting also, means making patterns or designs out of carving the wet sand. In that, Sudarshan Patnaik represented our country and he won the People's Choice Award in World Cup in the year 2014. He is the only person from India who participated in this competition. Till then, people did not know, people of India did not know that we can make a few beautiful patterns out of wet sand also. But other countries, so many people participated in this competition, but it was only Sudarshan Patnaik who represented our country, and a proud feeling is he got a prize for our country. World Cup for our country. What is the name of the prize? People's Award. And what was the art he represented there with the theme? Save tree, save future. For that he got an award. Which is it? People's Award. Understand how this art he learned. How did he learn this art? He himself did not know that such a beautiful art is hidden in him. Every person has one or the other art in himself. But the thing is, he should get correct exposure or correct encouragement, or he should have proper guidance, or he should have interest in doing it. Simply having any talent is not a matter. The matter is how we can use it, how we can develop it is a main thing. So, Sudarshan Patnaik belonged to the town Puri, Jagannath Puri in Odisha. Understand, he belonged to a very poor family. When he was 8 years old, his father left the house, leaving two more brothers, his mother and grandmother behind. So, his family, Sudarshan's family consisted of Sudarshan himself, his two brothers, his mother and grandmother. Understand, they were very poor people. They lived in a very, very small house. Understand, and when he reached 8 years, he had to stop going to school. Why? Because his mother could not afford or could not bear, she was not able to pay his school fee. So he stopped going to school. Then how to pass the time is a problem now. What did he do? He sat, his house was located near the sea beach. Near the sea beach. So every day he used to go to the seashore. And he used to observe the waves coming. And these waves, while coming and going back, they made a kind of pattern, design on the wet sand. Seeing that, he got a brilliant idea, very clever idea. This water waves, sea waves can leave some pattern behind. I am the human being. I also should try it. So, he wanted to do something, discover some art out of this wet sand. He did not have any pen, pencil, book, paper or paints at all. He made the long seashore as his drawing book. And he started making patterns out of the sand. He made the endless seashore. Means very, very long till where you see, you can see the seashore, length of the shore. So, such a big long seashore he made as his paper. And he decided to do some patterns out of it. His hands would do the work of the pencil. He dug his fingers into the wet and started making patterns. Patterns means designs. Understand? Slowly he started making big, big castles. Castles means big buildings, like big buildings, large buildings. So he made the patterns or models of the castles also. He loved it so much that he spent hours doing it. He used to spend lot of time doing such castles over there. Understand? Now he got developed some interest in doing that one. So he started coming to the beach every day. When Sudarshan turned 10 years, he had to work in other's house as a boy, as a servant, domestic servant. Because he had to feed his family, he had to support his family. But this problem did not stop him from, going to the sea or doing the sand patterns. What did he do? He went to the sea during the dawn, D-A-W-N, dawn means early morning, and at dusk, D-U-S-K, dusk means during the evening after his work is over. What did he do? Before going to the work and after coming from the work, he started going to the seashore and making the patterns. Understand? And he made sand castles over there. Slowly grew into big artworks. What sand castles he made, they were developed into big artworks. And with many different kind of connected parts. So, along with these castles, he used to do so many other designs also. People visiting the beach started noticing Sudarshan making sculptures out of sand. So, people come to the seashore now to pass their time for picnic or weekend like that. They started watching, means seeing Sudarshan's designs or sculptures which he made out of wet sand. Many even stopped by to praise him for his work. Stopped by means they stopped beside him and praised his work. Means they appreciated his work. One day, a tourist passing by saw Sudarshan working on a sculpture. The tourist told him that the nose of the figure was very large and looked abnormal. Sudarshan went back to the beach for the next few days and made the figure over and over again until people told him that the nose was perfect. So one day he was making the figure of a face. One tourist came to him and said that the nose is not correct. It is very long. Understand? So, he listened to that person. And every day he went and started correcting that part of the face. And He did it again and again until people said that nose is very correct. Shape of the nose is very correct. What you learn here? If anybody points out your mistake, don't feel bad. You should learn out of your mistake. Suppose your teacher says your handwriting is not good. So, she points out your mistake where you are logging back. So, what you have to do? You have to try to improve yourself, like Sudarshan. Anything you have wrong, you are not writing correct spellings, teacher says. So, you try to learn instead of feeling bad. Right, children? Same way, Sudarshan, as the tourist told him that the nose of the figure was very long, it is not correct. He did not feel bad. He went to the sea beach again and worked it on over and over, means again and again, to set right the shape of the nose. And till when he did this work? Till people said that the nose was right. Shape of the nose was perfect. Till then, he worked on that, correcting the shape of the nose. More and more people started noticing Sudarshan's beautiful sculptures. And now what happened? He started becoming famous. He used to be on the seashore and doing this work whenever he was free. And his sculpture designs became so famous. More and more people started coming to watch them, means to see them, notice them. Sudarshan has been making sand art for more than 30 years now. He still loves to try new things while working with sand. Now, by now, Sudarshan is doing this artwork, sand art, for 30 years. Even then, he doesn't feel that he is perfect. He wants to try new things. He wants to learn new patterns. So, this is our learning process is endless, children. Though I am a teacher, you think teacher knows everything. It is not like that. I am also a learner like you. How I teach, how I go on teaching you, I get new ideas. How best I can do, how best I can teach the children. Same way, practice is very important for us. So, though he works for 30 years, he did not stop practicing. He did not stop improving. He is practicing new patterns on with sand. He sometimes gives important messages through his sculptures. And his sculptures, his designs which he made or carved out of sand, give messages to the people. Some of his sculptures show important celebrations. Some show important people and events. So, what does he show through his patterns, through his designs on sand? He shows different celebrations, Independence Day, Republic Day, or Holi, Diwali, any festival, Durga Puja, like that. Or he makes the patterns of famous people like Abdul Kalam Azad, Gandhiji, Sachin Tendulkar, etc. Understand? And important celebrations, important events also he will do. In 2004, he created a sculpture appealing for help for the victims of Indian Ocean tsunami. In 2004, he made a sculpture appealing, means requesting the people to help the people who were affected by Indian Ocean tsunami. Do you know what is tsunami? Tsunami means very high waves strike to the seashore and they drain away, they wash away the houses, places which are close to the sea, like our earthquake, landslide, flood. Recently we met with corona. In that way, it is a natural calamity, nature's anger, we can say. Tsunami, T-S-U-N-A-M-I. Tsunami means very big waves occur in the sea. It happens because of the earthquake under the ground on the seabed. That's why. And they were 4-5 times higher than my height. They push away. They rush into the land side, which is close to the sea. And what do? They wash away everything. They affect the lives of the people. He also created beautiful sculptures dedicated to great leaders like Nelson Mandela and Mahatma Gandhi. He made the sculptures dedicating to Nelson Mandela, South African leader like Gandhiji. He also won Nobel Peace Prize. He has represented India in many international sand sculpting championships and festivals. He has also won many of those championships. Some of his sculptures have entered the Limca Book of Records. He has represented India in many competitions, in many championships. He won many championship awards also, and many of his sculptures entered Limca Book of Records. Sudarshan started the Sudarshan Sand Art Institute at Puri Beach to train artists. It is the first institute in India where people can learn sand art. So, after earning lot of money, what he did? He started his own institution, school, art school, where people can learn sand art. On the seashore, he opened his own school of sand art. So, people from our country go there to learn sand art. He was awarded the Padma Shri, the fourth highest civilian award in India in the year 2014 for his contribution in sand art. He was awarded Padma Shri for his great work, which is the greatest award of our country for the civilians, for citizens of India. So this is how, if he did not know, actually he lived in a small house, he did not go to school. He didn't even think that he had such a talent. But always going to the seashore, observing the waves, making patterns, this idea struck to his mind and he started working on it. And now he became the great artist, sand artist. And he got many prizes. He represented our country in many of the, competitions. So, this is our lesson, children. You people, please learn the lesson. Read the lesson. Once, I hope you have learnt what I said and you understood. Now, please open the book. I am going to read the lesson. You just listen and try to read it yourself. Okay. You must have heard of football or cricket World Cups, but did you know that there is a sand sculpting World Cup too? Sand sculpting is the art of making beautiful sculptures with sand. In the year 2014, Sudarshan Patnaik won the People's Choice Award at the World Cup for his work, Save Trees, Save the Future. Thousands of people voted for him. Artists from many countries took part in the competition and he was the only artist from India. Before Sudarshan became famous, most people in India did not even know about this type of art. Sudarshan himself discovered this art by chance. No one taught him how to make the sand sculptures. Sudarshan was born in 1977 in the town of Puri in Odisha. When Sudarshan was very young, his father left his family and went away. He lived in a small house with his two elder brothers, his mother and grandmother. By the time he turned 8, he had to leave school due to his family problems. His house was very close to the beach. He started spending more time at the beach. One day, Sudarshan sat at the beach watching the sea waves. He saw how the waves came to the shore and made patterns in the sand. Sudarshan loved art, but he never had enough money to buy pencils, paper, and paint. He had a brilliant idea. He decided to make the endless seashore his paper. His hands would do the work of a pencil. He dug his fingers into the wet sand and started making patterns. Slowly, he started making sand castles. He loved it so much that he spent hours doing it. Sudarshan started coming to the beach every day. When Sudarshan turned 10 years old, he had to start working as a domestic worker in his neighborhood. But this could not stop him away from the beach. He started visiting the beach at dawn and dusk, before and after his shift. His sand castles slowly grew into bigger artworks with many different and connected parts. People visiting the beach started noticing Sudarshan making sculptures out of sand. Many even stopped by to praise him for his work. One day, a tourist passing by saw Sudarshan working on a sculpture. The tourist told him that the nose of the figure was very large and looked abnormal. Abnormal means not normal. Sudarshan went back to the beach for the next few days and made the figure over and over again until people told him that the nose was perfect. More and more people started noticing Sudarshan's beautiful sculptures. Sudarshan has been making sand art for more than 30 years now. He still loves to try new things while working with sand. Sudarshan has been, he sometimes gives important messages through his sculptures. Some of his sculptures show important celebrations and some show important people and events. In 2004, he created a sculpture appealing for the help for the victims of Indian Ocean tsunami. He also created beautiful sculptures dedicated to great leaders like Nelson Mandela and Mahatma Gandhi. He has represented India in many international sand sculpting championships and festivals. He has also won many of those championships. Some of his sculptures have entered the Limca Book of Records. Sudarshan started the Sudarshan Sand Art Institute at Puri Beach to train artists. It is the first institute in India where people can learn sand art. He was awarded the Padma Shri, the fourth highest civilian award in India, in the year 2014 for his contribution in sand art. So this is the lesson. Please read it out. And tomorrow I will give you difficult words and meanings. So thank you, children.